While appearing before the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises, COSASE, chaired by Joel Senyonyi, in relation to a string of queries by the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2021-2022, the board chairperson of UNBS, Charles Moseruka, accused UNBS's Executive Director, David Livingstone Ebiru, for spending non-tax revenue amounting to 27 billion shillings for Pivocat source without approval of Parliament.
Whether the Council had the power to ask the Minister, the ED, to go on leave or not is not important to me. The Minister has been back for over 2 weeks. He left a grave matter on an important institution that is supposed to protect the public, and the Minister has done absolutely nothing.
I am the chairperson of the board, but I am failing to rein him, so he has run to us to say, please deal with the situation as Parliament. But we are going to get to the bottom of these issues.
In his response, Ebiru conceded to spending 27 billion shillings at source and explained that his decision to spend at source was informed by budget cuts. He acknowledged that his actions were illegal but necessary.
I need to fault you legally because you wrote to finance. You didn't get a response to finance from finance. You decided to take matters in your own hands and say, okay, since these people have not allocated more money, you took up the role of Parliament.
As I said, I did not believe that any legal advice will still solve this very difficult situation. So that's why I'm saying I will hand over myself, because I took it myself for the reasons I've given you, sir.
Among other allegations which Moseruka put before COSASE include 9.2 billion shillings, which was allegedly swindled by five staff charged with inspecting imports, namely Raymond Odiekol, Rogers Juko, Emmanuel Mwanguzi, Emmanuel Atei, and Bosco Luima, and no action was taken against them by management.
I wanted to bring it to your attention that the 9.28 billion was not the only money that has been lost and is known. If you look at that attachment, you will be very, very surprised what goes on at this institution.
Moseruka also told the committee that the executive director withdrew 330 million shillings from the collection account at Stanbic Bank and spent it at source without authority. Another claim is on the rampant cash withdrawals.
The Bureau, Mr. Chairperson, is running like a private shop of some people. It is up to this committee to rescue this situation. Personally, I think we cannot cover up these things.
After tabling his evidence before the committee, UNBS Executive Director Ebiru stunned the committee when he referred to the board chairperson as a spy and asked COSASE to task Moseruka on the authenticity of these documents.
To confirm that this chairman is a spy, he has been spying from day one, and you can imagine that all this information he has handed you have no information about it. I've just come to also see it here. That's why, Chair, I thank you for giving me this. And to ask that you first of all calm down, yeah, because you don't want to bias us against you, because he has leveled, your chairman, your supervisor has leveled allegations and he has provided documents. Okay, so respond to the documents.
Moseruka didn't even spare the Minister of Trade, whom he accused of exempting several companies from paying 15% of fines for importing unclear goods.
Mr. Chairperson, a lot of goods come to this country and without any clearance from overseas. A lot of goods. When they get here, we are supposed to penalize them 15% of CIF value, and then they pay destination charges. There are letters, boxes of letters, exempting traders from paying this money.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.